Hello everyone, this is me Hafiz Mohammed Ataullah, and today we are discussing about Git and GitHub. So basically Git is a free and open source version control software, and basically that means content tracker. What does mean by Git? Git means content tracker. So Git can be used to store content, and it is most used to store code because of other features is provided, you know. So real-time projects generally have multiple developers working in parallel, so they need a version control system like Git to make sure that there are no code conflict between them, and also requirements in such project change often. So a version control system allows developer to, you know, revert and like go back to an older version of their code. So we are gonna create a repository using Git. So before this, I'm just, wait a second. Okay. So wait a second again. Okay. So what is GitHub repository? So if we want to start using Git, we need to know where to host our repository. Basically, repository, or short form in repo, is a project that contains multiple files. In our case, repository will contain code-based file. You know, there are two ways you can host your repository. One is online, means on the cloud, and the second is offline, that means self installed on your you know, in your server. So there are three popular Git hosting services. First is GitHub, this is owned by Microsoft, this one, and second one is GitLab, this is owned by GitLab. Okay, so GitLab, this is second. Okay, so and third one is basically Bitbucket, this is GitHub services. Wait a second. Okay, so third one is Bitbucket. So before using Git, we should know why we need it basically. So basically Git makes it easy to contribute to open source projects, and nearly every open source project uses GitHub to manage their projects. Using GitHub is a free if your project is open source, and it includes a wiki, and it includes a issues tracker that makes it easy to include more in-depth documentation and get feedback, you know, about your project. So if you want to contribute, you just fork, means get a copy of a project, make your changes, and then send the project a pull request using GitHub web interface. So they'll pull request is your way of telling your project you are ready for them to review your changes, right? So by using GitHub, you can make it easier to get excellent documentation. You can integrate with common platforms such as Amazon, Google Cloud, and you know, Code Climate to track your feedback, and Azure and other Google and other cloud platforms. You can either track changes in your code across versions. Also, you can showcase your work. Also, you can because nowadays when searching for new you know, recruits for their projects, most companies look at GitHub profile. If your profile is available, you will have a higher chance of being recruited, even if you are not from a grateful university or college. So to create your account, you need to go to a GitHub website and fill out the registration form. From here, sign up from sign up button. If you are using Ubuntu, you have to write some commands. But if you are using Windows, simply create the repository. Before this, enter your email, enter your password, and enter your username and etc. So I'm gonna work with my own GitHub so that we have to create an repository. Okay, so simply sign in your account with your email and password. Okay, so wait a minute. Okay, so create the repository, clone it to your PC and work in on it. So basically just click on new button and you have to create a new repository. So pick a name for your first repository, add a small description, then check initialize this repository with readmap, and you know, then create button. So first you have, what you have to do is you have to assign your first GitHub repository name, that is basically navtech for suppose. Okay, and navtech material, this is my optional description. Okay, so now add a readme file. You can choose a license, you can use MIT license, or either you can also use GNU or BSD and etc. Okay, so this repository is already exist on this account. Okay, so navtech 2, okay, this is available. Now create your repository. Now work on your project locally, then create the repository on GitHub and push it to remote. Like, so let you make a fresh repository from an existing folder on your computer and send that to GitHub. So in a lot of cases you might have actually already made something of on your computer that you want to suddenly turn it into a repository on GitHub. Like I'm creating a website. So creating a file, like, okay, so main.py. okay, so I'm writing first program for, you know, I'm gonna save this and upload this to my GitHub repository. So first you have to add file, then create new file, or either you can upload files. Choose your files, main.py. okay, so commit changes. File is uploaded. Now you can check your, yeah, this one, languages Python 100%. Okay, so now in a lot of cases you might have actually already made something on your computer in this case, right? And but lot of cases you might have actually not already made something on your computer, but you have to create a new file. So in this case you have to create your new file, and what you have to do is index dot HTML. Okay, so you can write your code okay, so commit new file. But by default any directory on our computer is not a GitHub repository, but we can turn it into a GitHub repository by executing some following command like GitHub init or git init. I can write these commands to wait a minute. Okay, so you can use git init. This command is used for the executing the following command, and you know, after converting our repository to a git repository, the first thing we need to do is to check the files we have to using the following command, like git status. Okay, so now there are two files in that you may receive the directory that we need to add our repo. So you can use git add and file 1 and 2. Like file 1 is basically main.py and index.html. Okay, so now you have, what you have to do is you have to add your git using this command. After the staging area, we can check whether the files are successfully added or not by executing the git status. You can use this git status for successful adding or not. So in those particular files are the greenish color. That means it's a successful commit, and then we have to commit with a description in it. So if my repository started on GitHub and I brought it down to my computer, a remote is already going to be attached it. So but I am starting my repository on my computer, it doesn't have a remote associated with it, so I need to add that remote type 2, right? So after clicking the after executing this command, we can check whether we have successfully added the remote or not by changing the name, origin, and other stuff.